Welcome to Module 6, Part 2. Lighting science. Lights can act both a detective and a deterrent control. A light that allows a guard to see an intruder is acting as a detective control. Criminals will usually favor a poorly lit target over a more visible one, so light can also act as a deterrent control. Light should be bright enough to illuminate the desired field of vision. This is a very important point. Lighting is a commonly used form of perimeter security control. The primary purpose of lighting is to discourage casual intruders, trespassers, or would-be thieves who would rather perform their misdeed in the dark. That is how it's important. The light should be bright enough to illuminate the desired field of vision. Security guards. Guards are dynamic control. We call it dynamic control because they can do many more things. Guards may aid in inspection of the access credentials, monitor CCTV, monitor environmental controls, respond to incidents, act as a deterrent. Everything he can do, that's why we say it's a dynamic control. But at the same time, that's the weakest link in the security chain. The reason why we say it's the weakest chain means, in information security, the prime importance is given for the human life. If the very human life is under threat, he may reveal what he knows to the attackers. That's how we say that the humans are the weakest link in the security chain. Alarms. Perimeter alarms include magnetic door and window alarms. They include matched pairs of sensors on the wall as well as windows or door. An electrical circuit flows through the sensor pairs as long as the door or window is closed. The circuit breaks when either is opened. So this is not the normal situation. This is. These are often armed for secured areas as well as in general areas during off hours such as nights or weekends. Once armed, a central alarm system will alert when any door or window is open. Trained dogs provide perimeter defense duties. Dogs primarily serve as both deterrent and detective control. A site without a dog is more likely to be physically attacked than a site with dogs, that is a deterrent control. And the dogs alert the security guards through barking, that is what the detective control. Most security dogs are trained to corner a suspect. They are usually trained not to bite if the intruder is not moving. If you happen to be in a secured area and in front of the dogs, you're not supposed to move. You should be standing there. Because the dogs usually trained not to bite if the intruder is not moving. And the dogs are trained to attack a fleeing suspect. That's what it is. Unfortunately, many people do not know this, or simply they panic and run at the sight of menacing dog guard. Anyway, you can't beat him. Tragedies have occurred when authorized personnel accidentally leave a building and enter a secured area between the building and the fence perimeter, such as accidentally leaving via a fire door. So the point to be taken from here is, if at all you happen to be in front of the dog in a secured area, you're not supposed to move. You have to simply stand there. Man trap. A man trap is a preventive physical control with two doors. Let's see the picture of the man trap and come back to this slide. This is the picture of a man trap. This is the secured area and there are two doors for this cabin. If a person gets into the first door with his credential, and he must provide the second set of credentials to open the second door and enter into the secured area. If an intruder comes and opens this first door, he'll be trapped inside because he does not know the second set of credentials to open this door. That is what is man trap. Let's go back to the slide. A man trap is a preventive physical control with two doors. The first door must close and lock before the second door may be opened. Each door typically requires a separate form of authentication to open. A common combination is a PIN, personal identification number, and a biometric. The intruder is trapped in between the doors after entering the man trap. Turnstiles are designed to prevent tailgating by enforcing a 1 person per authentication rule. Secure data centers often use floor-to-ceiling turnstiles with interlocking blades to prevent an attacker from going over or under the turnstile. This is what the picture of a turnstile, and the blades are there from bottom to the roof, and if one person enters here, it will turn like this so that you can go out. If at all there is one person coming inside, and that as it turns, you can come inside. So tailgating can be prevented by the turnstile. Fire suppression. Heat detectors, flame detectors, and smoke detectors provide 3 methods for detecting fire in the corporate environment. They typically alert locally and may also be centrally monitored by a fire alarm. In addition to creating an audible alarm, flashing lights should also be used so that both deaf and blind personnel will be aware of the alarm. Heat detectors alert when temperature exceeds an established safe baseline. They may trigger when the specific temperature is exceeded or when the temperature changes at specific rate. For example, if the temperature exceeds 10 degree Fahrenheit in less than 5 minutes, then the heat detectors will detect it and give an alarm. Cameras. Closed circuit television, CCTV, is a detective device used to aid guards in detecting the presence of intruders in restricted areas. CCTVs using the normal light spectrum require sufficient visibility to eliminate the field of view that is visible to the camera. This is very important aspect of the security, physical security awareness and training. The very important aspect of good security practice is training and awareness. Better educated team of firewall administrators and users make the environment secured. Even if the best equipment and devices deployed, without proper training, it cannot be optimally used. The point is, we need to include everybody in the organization from various departments for training and awareness. The reason is, the security is everyone's responsibility. Let's take the concept challenge. Question number 1. The first line of defense. Physical security. Question number 2. 4 physical security control types. Detective, corrective, recovery, and deterrent. Question number 3. A heavy fine for speeding of vehicle is a dash control. What control is it? Deterrent control. Question number 4. This is a preventive physical control with 2 doors. Man trap. Question number 5. A dynamic control that may be used in a variety of situations. Guards. Thank you for watching. Let's move to module 7.